If a Durham public school had 100 students, 19 of them would be white, 44 would be African American, 30 would be Hispanic, 3 would be Asian, and 4 would be multiracial. If the same school had a gifted education program, 41 of the students would be white, 33 would be African American, 16 would be Hispanic, 5 would be Asian, and 5 would be multiracial. Obviously, someone is underrepresented here. Our project aims to fix this racial disparity as well as give all students access to a curriculum that can advance each student's individual learning abilities.
That's where we get started. Our project is stemmed out of Project Bright Idea, piloted in 2004. Project Bright Idea's main goal was to improve the numbers of minority students within gifted education programs in North Carolina. Project Bright Idea also aimed to teach teachers how to believe in the potential of all of their students. The most effective part of Project Bright Idea was the thinking skills curriculum, which helped diversify the population of students performing at the gifted level within North Carolina public schools.
Now this brings us into our project, implementing the thinking skills curriculum in 2 Durham public schools. We wanted to do this not only to enhance each student's educational prosperity and cognitive abilities, but to show teachers that every student in their classroom can learn using a cognitive systematic approach and have teachers stray away from their racially biased preemptive expectations on their students' achievement.
There are several goals within the implementation of the thinking skills curriculum for students and teachers. What these goals allow the student to do is think about their thinking, what we like to call metacognition. Metacognition is the number one thing about a confident learner that the learner possesses. There are several goals for the students, such as cooperation and thinking together and speaking in full sentences for the entire class period. What this allows the student to do is talk about how they learned what they learned, therefore advancing their metacognitive skills.
Before we implemented the curriculum, we gave teachers a survey in order for us to chart their progress of their attitudes on their students' achievement. Then teachers went through professional development. Once they started teaching the thinking skills curriculum in their classrooms, we went in for observations regarding the implementation. Teachers had a second professional development, as well as there were periodic check-ins with them in order to chart their progress and concerns.
This couldn't have been done without the help of 2 Durham public schools, Pearsontown Elementary and Forest View Elementary, within which there were a total of 13 female teachers involved.
From the survey we gave to the teachers regarding their attitudes, we saw that 6 teachers strongly agreed that they could teach every student in their classroom to think critically. Furthermore, 7 teachers strongly agreed that they could use activities with high-level expectations for all of their students. Yet, in contrast to both of these results, 9 teachers agreed that regardless of their efforts, there would still be students in their classroom that could not master the material. We see this as a room of growth as further teacher development and classroom strategies continue to shape teachers' attitudes on their students.
For our classroom visits, what our team used was a standard observational checklist, which assessed the progress of the lesson. What this allowed us to do is think about the advancements and the prohibitions regarding the curricula in terms of the student and teacher development mentioned earlier.
We saw that teachers did well in terms of preparedness, adherence to the curriculum script, as well as encouraging their students to use high-level vocabulary. Some challenging areas for the teachers included using an essential question for each curriculum lesson, as well as prompting their students to think critically with one another. And now here's a glimpse into the thinking skills curriculum in Pearsontown Elementary School.
One learner I have learned from my smart books so far is 4. My favorite thing about this big book is the color and line. This is writing and coloring.
Metacognition is when you're thinking about your thinking.
It's when you're thinking about your thinking. Great job.
These are not
equal.
See if they both were equal and the same size.
It doesn't stop here. Our hopes for the future are to implement a curriculum in Durham Public Schools so that students get a wider exposure to the curriculum across several years. What we also aim to do is approach teachers and tell them to think about a more optimistic, persistent, and positive way to approach their students in that they can believe in each student can learn fully. We hope that more Durham Public Schools will begin to recognize curricula like this.
And this is our team. Thank you.